Oh, that is not medium sand. That is like light. Hey everybody, so today we're gonna be doing a really fresh and glowy wear test, trying out a bunch of new e.l.f. products. I'm not going full beat glam today. I'm just not about it. I'm traveling in less than 48 hours. I need to pack, I need to run errands, but I do want to go out to lunch with my husband and look a little something, but keep, you know, my face presentable yet light. You know what I'm saying? That's the vibe for today. It's like less is more, but I want a wear test. So I have had the new e.l.f. 16 hour camo concealers for maybe 2 weeks now. I ordered them on Ulta and then I got 3 shades, but I saw that they were sending out the whole line of concealers to those on their PR list, and I decided to wait for that package because I thought that would be more helpful to everyone to see the full line swatched. So I do have that now. I also purchased some of their newer products, the ones that come in like this light blush color. We have the matte blotting mist, which seems innovative and possibly terrifying, and then we have the glow primer stick because glowing, hello. We got a blush, we got a powder, I'm gonna rock some brows. It's about it. It's gonna be pretty simple today. We're not doing a foundation wear test, so I'm just gonna use mainly the concealer to help me out. The PR box is adorable. So this is a camo box, obviously. And the top says, you know, story time with Sam. What do you do in 16 hours? With hustling to work, running to the gym, and everything in between, your concealer needs to play as much as you do. That's why we created this concealer, a lightweight, full coverage concealer that hits all the high points of your face and wallet. Etc. Spreads, it's lightweight, and it has a flawless matte finish. So these are all 18 shades, and they did give a little sample of the doe foot applicator. It's so plushy looking. This is how it comes when you purchase it on Ulta or e.l.f.'s website. And in the PR box, they gave a little guide for undertones, which shades are cool, which shades are neutral, which shades are warm. So I'll put that up on the screen so you guys can check it out. And I'm also gonna give you guys swatches of all 18 shades so you can see the full line. So I'd also like to mention that I did pick up their Pore Putty Primer that is supposed to be the affordable dupe comparison to the Tatcha Silk Canvas, which I love and adore, but that's gonna be its own separate video because I wanna wear test this with a foundation, full face, all that stuff, and see how these are versus half and half. That's coming up soon, but not in this video. I think it's just too much going on with the primer and concealer if I haven't even used the concealer before, if that makes sense. So we're gonna go in and start priming. I'm gonna use the Glow Primer Stick with Coconut and Shea Butter. It comes with the full amount of the barrel right here. It looks kind of like a jumbo glue stick, even color wise. It's very interesting. You guys might notice my eye's super red right here. I woke up with a situation going on with that eye. It's fine, it's just a little red, so I'm okay. That's mainly why we're not gonna do anything with my eye area right now. I just kind of gonna give it a break, but we are gonna prime this side of the face. It has a wet feeling to it. It's not hard like a lot of stick foundations are. It is sticky for sure. I realized that maybe I shouldn't have pulled it too far in. So we're gonna avoid the nose area and just kind of keep it around here. My skin is already hydrated, but I'm hoping this doesn't turn me into a grease ball. I'm gonna take a little bit and just pat it on the under eye. I do like how easily it does melt into the skin and kind of turns into a liquid. That's cool. For my eyebrows, I'm going to try out their new Ultra Precise Brow Pencil in Taupe. I haven't tried a lot of e.l.f.'s products in a while. I gave this palette a go the other day and it, the blush in my skin tone was not, But I have so many fun things from them that I want to use. So aside from this review, I probably will do some sort of full face with e.l.f. later. Brow pencil better not play me. I'm going to be mad. A little soap in the brow. So likely when you are watching this, I've either just come home or I'm still in New York, but I couldn't resist filming today. I could have just waited till I got back, done the safer thing, but nah. I guess I don't always live the less is more mantra. Also, I will have a new Wet n Wild foundation video coming up. I'm gonna film that right when I get back because I was also waiting on a box from them so I could show you guys a lot of their new products compared to just the primer and the foundation, which I bought earlier. So I've been really going hard with the soap brow look, as you can see, especially when I look back, you can see all the little flutteries. But I do have a little gap right there where I could use like one extra stroke and probably like one right here. So I'm just gonna do the minimal. Go in the direction of hair growth. This is a harder formula for sure. Maybe it hasn't melted yet, but It's a little dense. Whenever I review e.l.f., I think about my first e.l.f. review, which was, you know, very early on in my channel. It was one of the first videos that did decently, like, well, number-wise. It was, like, shocking. That was when e.l.f. first came out, and everyone was like, what the heck? And I remember how long it used to take to get their product shipping-wise. It used to drive me nutsos. But e.l.f. has grown so much in the last, what is it, 8 or 9 years since then? Or it's maybe 10, because it's almost 10 years for me. I'm 10 years in May. This looks really good. I like the color, and I like the pencil. Now, the primer feels still a little tacky, but in like a nice hydrating way compared to like slippery and hasn't like absorbed yet. So let's jump into the concealer. I love how their tagline is, for days when you didn't wake up like this. So for reference point, we're kind of just taking the medium shades and the last light shade right now, which I believe are the same shades that I purchased. So for the last light shade that I pulled out, that would be light beige, and I thought this would be good for my under eyes because it is a yellow, and they classify it as a warm undertone. Under the eyes we go. I remember when people still dotted on their concealer. I mean, some people still do. Ain't nothing wrong with that. Okay, so this is definitely in my zone. Wow, it is. It's really matte, but really nice and opaque. Yet still pretty creamy right now because I don't think it's set yet. I'm just gonna highlight that area. Bring it in over here. You can already see a huge difference. And coming in close, it looks good right now. I'm not gonna give it too much time to play around, so I'm gonna keep an eye on that because it is matte. I want it to dry down without too much of a crease. There's nothing really to inspect about that yet. I'm gonna do the other eye. Definitely has a little force in it when you put the applicator back in the vacuum, like, oh god, something's in my eye. Y'all like my ginormous lopsided bun? It's not the look for today. That's just how I slept and I haven't touched it yet. We real over here, okay? We not always polished and pretty. Sometimes we're busted and crusted. But these under eyes though are not. I like the shade. Good shade for the under eyes, twinsies. I'm gonna set this with their Correct and Set Eye Powder. It's really tiny, but this is in banana. I'm gonna at least try to. I don't know if this banana is gonna be okay for me because it does say deep tone, which kind of freaks me out. I hate when the freaking label is so small. Ta and da. Okay, I just use a little bit and I don't want to mess with it too much because it is already a matte concealer, but I don't want it to crease, so just a little bit. You could probably get away with it if you don't get oily around here, but I would hate for my oils to come break up the rest of the concealer. Now for the other skin shade. So I originally picked up medium beige and medium sand, so we'll look at those. Oh, that is not medium sand. That is like light. This is the eighth shade, and that to me does not look like what the little circle and the swatch looks like online. This is pale. This is really pale. For laughs and giggles, we're gonna put light beige, what I just put underneath my eyes next to it. Look, light beige is almost the exact same thing except for a different tone. So medium sand is described as a neutral tone, and that's shade number 8. So the next shade up from that is medium beige, which is a warm tone, which kind of just touched it, sorry. That's a crazy big jump from 8 to 9, in my opinion. That's like unheard of. Let's put shade 7, which is medium peach, which we know isn't gonna work. That's shade 7, so there's 7, 8, and 9. This ain't gonna work. This is shade 10, tan sand. I don't really like what's going on right now. I'm glad I waited for the package because I would have been extra screwed if I was only stuck with these two shades. I wouldn't know what to do with myself. Of course, I would have made it work, but it's not ideal. So we're gonna mix up something and figure out how to make this work. So tan sand at least has the undertone I'm looking for. Maybe that mixed with my under eye shade will do what I need it to do. I do hate that the inside of the barrel gets so gunky because of how big the applicator is. I mean, what you gonna do? The stopper can only stop so much, but that's just something like you gotta watch out for. You don't want to get too gunked up and splatter everywhere on you. Medium beige is not the business because it's kind of orangey on me. So maybe medium sand, that oddly light thing, maybe that. And then we'll take the sample applicator and just So I thought about it for a moment. I'm like, wasn't I just supposed to spot conceal? because I have it all over my face now. I was trying to go for that glowy thing. That's the problem when your problematic area is your cheek. It's not looking too much different than my under eye, which is sad. Lightness, whatever's left on my sponge on. The rest of my nose and forehead. A little pounce pounce here, a little pounce pounce there. It's darker in the mixture than it does on the face. We're gonna give it a second to set. But otherwise, I'm gonna take tan sand. You see the redness? And you're thinking to yourself, Sam, why would you want that part of your face to be darker? I don't, but it's not that dark. See, I'm just trying to find some yellow back in my face. Tan sand would probably just work in the summertime for me. Look what happened to light and glow. We just have to mix a little yellow. Trying to bridge that gap right now. It does set just a tad bit darker. I'm not gonna set the concealer around my face because I think the matter finish is enough right now. And then we'll get to test out the matte blotting spray later when I get oily. We're gonna try the e.l.f. Primer Infused Blush in Always Cheeky. The one thing that e.l.f. hasn't changed is their tiny labels. Y'all, can we get a little bit bigger, a little upgrade for 2020? Just asking, because sometimes it's really hard to read it. With my collab multitasking brush. It says the blush is infused with a primer, lock-on primer powder to ensure a full day of perfectly placed blush. So I'm actually going to be using a roll-on highlighter, and this is by Kaja. It's gonna be its own separate quick video because it seems appropriate since I'm sure I'll get a lot of questions about it. So we are back and we are glowing. Here we are. Ooh, ooh. Ooh, so I'm going to use the Modern Metals Gloss. Ooh. Oh. Oh. It's like a really strong vanilla. Something else too. It's really, really strong. Girlactic's Naked. I'm gonna pat it on. Really lightly. Just in the center. There we go. That looks a lot better to me. It's natural, still feels really light on the lips, not too defined, not too much like a liquid lipstick, but it gives us a little. That was annoying. I do have a little bit of an issue with my nose though. I can see the pores a lot, so I'm gonna try to maybe put a little on there. Hope it doesn't destroy us right now. Can you hide these pores? Does it work like that? I have like a weird yellow patch now. Great, great, Sam, good job. That was a bad idea because it didn't really fix the nose issue. You can see that big yellow cast now in the middle of my face. So just a little translucent powder. Try to even that area out. It's still kind of.
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not.
Yellow. Whatever. We're done. Let's just get the pictures on the screen. So, it's not too late in the evening. It's 6:13, so we've been wearing this for a little over 7 hours. Not the longest wear test ever, but I think I got my opinion. So obviously I look crazy because I have a huge yellow section over my nose, like a nose strip, which basically was a huge mistake and I shouldn't have done it. I kept staring at it all day. Like, I was a little embarrassed to go out to eat. Like, I felt like I looked kind of sunburnt, but like, almost like I had a really bad fake tan in a way, because it was just like a weird color. But that's what I get for trying to add certain spots with the more golden tone tan sand. So let's talk about the shades real quick. Can we, please? Thank you. After checking out all of the concealers, I want to say that this probably doesn't matter to everyone, or maybe it does because it could also be the same way they show the swatches online. The swatches that are in these little circles right here do not match the colors in the tube at all to me. They all look very different, especially undertone wise. That's possibly just some bad, you know, graphic design color accuracy, so that might not, you know, be the best way to showcase your shades, because certain ones, for example, medium sand, you see that? That would be, I believe, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, this shade right here, and it's so much darker. And even down to the warm undertones of the deep shades, the darkest shade doesn't look anything like that. The darkest shade to me is warm. Look very cool, but it's actually very red to me. I don't think they look alike at all. So those are just some examples. I just find it a little misleading and also very confusing. After swatching all of the shades, I swatched fair, light, and medium together and tan, deep, and rich together just so I could, number one, have space, and number two, get a good picture of it all. So fair all looks the same to me. Shade 1, 2, and 3 and shade 5 look very similar. I even asked my husband. Of course, men don't really see the difference sometimes, but he's like, no, in the tube and on your arm, it looks the same, though they're supposed to have different undertones. And I understand being swatched on someone who isn't fair, maybe the undertones aren't coming through. So I do want to put that disclaimer. Certain things swatched on other people, you might not get that accuracy, but to me, I can't even tell the slightest different. I'm not trying to stir up trouble. I'm just trying to be honest on my observations. And then the light section, I could see a difference in tones. The medium section is just a flop, in my opinion. It is nowhere near medium. That's where the gap is in this gradient. There is no really good medium shades, in my opinion. A lot of them are light and then it just jumps into tan. The medium, though, my zone, there was a lot of work to be done, and I don't see a cool, a neutral, or a medium warm. 18 could have been done a lot better. So that's my opinion on the shade range. Now let's get into the formula. I'm not gonna knock e.l.f. for obviously user error, because I shouldn't have done what I did when I tried to cover my nose, and I paid for it, obviously, and who looks like a fool? Me. I look like a fool. If I had medium shades, though, this would have happened. So I'm gonna sprinkle like 5% of the blame on e.l.f. on that one. I don't love the formula, though. I'm gonna be blunt, honest, and just to the point. It is very full coverage. I'll give them that. It is pretty weightless. Another good claim. It is not long wearing to me. On the oil control aspect, it did a decent job. It's very matte, and it did wear decent without a powder, and I did powder it on my eyes, and it's still very matte there. I am starting to get a little greasy around my actual oily areas, but it's not too bad at this current 7 to almost 8 hour mark. But my pores, especially here, not up here, but my pores here and across my nose, are getting more and more visible as we speak, and I will give you a close-up clip with my smaller camera. It is very apparent that it looks like I almost have like little holes in my face, which are obviously actually holes because they're pores. And in this little region, I'll give you guys a close-up, it's getting cakey and heavy looking. It was a lot smoother and a lot more flawless, I'll say. Back when it was first applied, it's starting to crack around my smile lines, and generally it's not looking as good overall. I think in pictures I look kind of crazy. You can see all the shade differences, obviously, and it could have been slightly avoided, but at the same time, I don't know what else I was supposed to do with the shades that I could be using. I only wanted to use this as an under eye concealer and picked up light beige, which is what I'm wearing. Wearing it with a different foundation, all that, it would have been fine. It's not the best concealer. It wiped away pretty easily because I had like dog hair stuck in my eye, so I just went like this and I lost my whole inner corner. It definitely is settling into my major line and giving me a little separation. It's not horrible, but a little separation under there. And I couldn't imagine wearing it without it being set, because then it would wipe off easily, just because that's a very, you know, wrinkly, motion happens a lot there. And for its claim that says it goes with you to the gym and work and all this stuff, all I did was go eat lunch and I went to the chiropractor, which I think are very normal tasks. And the weather was great today. It wasn't raining, it wasn't overly humid, it wasn't anything too crazy, it wasn't super cold. So to not see the results that I think they claimed for kind of disappoint me, because it's definitely coming off my face. I had to lay face down in the chiropractor chair, and I didn't get like yanked around or anything like that, but just touching, you know, the almost like toilet cover type of material, you saw a lot of my face on there. My chiropractor was like, filming day, huh? Because this whole section seemed to just right off, since it's not super set. I personally prefer it when I can find a shade for my under eyes and my skin. I know that might not be everyone's wants, but I would like that. It's a no from me in many standpoints. I like what they were going for. I like the claims they were aiming for, the amount of shades, the price point, and all of that. I just don't think they hit the mark on it. So the brow pencil, not bad. The blush, not bad. The powder, I would try it again. So this glow primer stick didn't make a difference in anything. I look exactly the same on both sides in every aspect of smoothness, glowiness, long wearness. It didn't do it for me, but I will give it a go with something else. I have like swatch marks on my hand. This is gonna be the fun part, though. So though I'm not super oily, I still wanna give this matte blotting mist a go. It has Kaolin Clay. It gives your skin a touchless touch-up. Okay, I'm getting a little something. So here we are. Test Fritz. Oh, Jesus. It smells great. It smells like rose water. Oh, great. Did I just play myself? I can see the clay at the bottom of the bottle. It's really hard to see, but there's like a thickness at the bottom right there. And I might have just played myself because it says to shake thoroughly. Instructions. And it doesn't seem to be unclumping, so I'm worried that I might have just sprayed my face with just clay, but kind of giving Too Faced matte setting spray a go because they have the same thing. But if y'all saw my review, it didn't work out for me no matter how much I shook it, so let's just hope this doesn't have. What am I doing with my hands? Oh, we see what happened to my lipstick. It like took the lipstick off. It does dry to a matte finish for sure, but did it actually help or is it taking off my makeup? The areas of my nose were fading, but now because of the spray, it has kind of accentuated the fading. It made the lines more apparent of where there is makeup and where there isn't makeup. So I'm not sure if I like that. I'm gonna give it a just okay. I'm not hating on it. I'll try it again some other time when I really, really need it. Honestly and truly, I'm kind of sick of all the matte. If you enjoyed this review, give this video a thumbs up. If you want to check out my recent videos, they'll be over here. And if you haven't already, feel free to subscribe by clicking the button down below and join our family. We love new additions. I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys in a later video. Attractive.